2018 economy goes cold, inflation hot. Danielle DiMartino Booth, former Fed insider. Danielle DiMartino Booth is not optimistic about a surging economy in 2018. Booth contends, "We have seen 24 consecutive back-to-back months when credit card spending has outpaced incomes. That tells you households are struggling to get by. This is not Yves Saint Laurent handbags and Jimmy Choo shoes. These are families who are using their credit cards to take care of the necessities, to fill up the gas tank, to buy groceries, and fill up their refrigerator. We have seen month after month of subprime automobile delinquencies, and we are starting to see a big tick up in FHA mortgage delinquencies as well. We are at almost 10% delinquencies of FHA mortgage loans. Underlying this sugar high that we will see from all of these hurricanes and rebuilding efforts and wildfires, underneath that, still waters run deep, and the economy is not doing well. We are a consumption-driven economy that is weakening underneath. The sugar high will absolutely wear off in 2018. What about the bond market in 2018? Booth says, "We have gone from $150 trillion in global debt in 2007 to $220 trillion and counting today. If you delude yourself into thinking a rising rate environment can be good when we have tacked on $70 trillion of debt in the last decade, you are fooling yourself. It is an accident waiting to happen, and anyone who doesn't think that it will take the stock market down with it is more optimistic than I am by a country mile." Booth says, along with the bond market debacle, the world will see inflation right along with it. Booth explains, "Look at lumber prices, look at the cost of packaging, plastics, raw materials, the producer price index is at a six-year high right now. It is called the mother of all margin squeezes. Companies are suffering. We have inflation. We have very real inflation, and it is hitting corporate America between the eyes. We have seen inflation happening, and we continue to see it happening. Rental inflation is off the scale. Inflation is up for 2018, and it has been up. We can have deflation and inflation at the same time. If all of this debt that has built up, especially for households, if they are allocating more of their income to servicing debt, then they have fewer dollars to spend on other things. So, you are going to have deflation and inflation at the same time. What does the regular guy on the street do?" Booth says, "Figure out a way to have exposure to precious metals. Put your bubble vision on mute. You do not have to be invested in the market. That is a fallacy. Take what you have and pay down your debts." Join Greg Hunter as he goes one-on-one with former Fed insider Danielle DiMartino Booth, author of the popular book Fed Up. Investing, making it more accessible for the average citizen. One links their Facebook account to the bank, and an investment portfolio is generated. And for nearly no cost, seemingly preposterous. Or is it? This article will explore the shifts in views in investing, new opportunities in the market, and how investing will become a common practice for the average citizen. Should I invest in Bitcoin or Tesla? This a common question from a friend to anyone in the field of finance. Although the average citizen is still skeptical of the financial markets, it is very difficult to ignore the returns people are making with cryptocurrencies. Bank savings. No one likes to earn 1% interest on their bank account, or even lower, and lack the flexibility to withdraw whenever they wish. On the other hand, The average citizen is either too afraid to go into investing, or does not trust the system. Hence the idea of earning a high return on their cash becomes a distant reality for many. How and why then will that citizen place their money elsewhere? Goals of a portfolio manager. Before looking into potential investors, it is perhaps wise to inspect the future of the asset management profession. Setting aside the intricate levels within the industry, a person who manages someone else's money has one objective and one restriction: to provide the expected returns, according to the risk tolerance of the investor. Within this framework, the portfolio managers gather data and, using their knowledge, transmute data into investment returns. The future of finance investigating and outlining a path for the future of professions. Richard and Daniel Susskind focus on the creation and distribution of knowledge. In a nutshell, they argue that most professions will be focused on production and distribution of practical expertise. Such evolution will ease the transition to automation, with i.e., where distribution channels will use the internet to deliver personalized and cheaper solutions to customers. At the end of the day, the financial professions known for their monopoly over investment knowledge will lose ground to smarter and faster acting systems. Opportunity equals attention. A lucrative business model appears at this point. Entrepreneurs investing in IE could reap the rewards by targeting the masses, as processing data and providing personalized responses become extremely cheap. IBM's Watson can connect society to social media and track an investor's habits, thoughts, or preferences. Consequently, the common citizen can receive a personalized portfolio that is usually only available to high-net-worth individuals. Using this structure, IEs like Watson can invest in ETFs or even attempt to filter stocks that meet their clients' preferences. The final picture is the combination of IE and personalized ETF/stock portfolios for the masses, those who cannot afford asset managers and do not want the lower rates at banks. Win-win? Although some argue that a good deal for the consumer is bad news for the business owner, this is a unique situation. By providing tailored marketing and sales to clients, the wealth managers can increase their retention and satisfaction rates. And adopting this methodology to serve a larger audience, they can maintain their margins while boosting their inflows. The sacrifice in earnings for growth prospects may not be as harsh as it is in standard business models. Since the attention they're required by the masses is handled by IE, wealth managers can focus on their investment strategies. The counterargument: so if investing is so easy, who needs intermediaries? Why would anyone want to pay a fund manager when one could build its own portfolio of ETFs or stocks? At this point, it is sensible to bring up the Apple versus Android argument. Many techies would argue how an Android phone is superior in technical specifications and in its flexibility and customization. Yet, even under such scrutiny, many go ahead and buy an iPhone. How so? Because the numbers are not the only factors that one takes into account when making a decision. The seamless purchase, easy access to support and beauty are all qualitative perspectives that prompt people to buy an iPhone. And on top of that, people do not want to overthink. They need a tool for an application and something that solves that conveniently takes their attention. A similar scene is evident in the field of investment. People do not want to think or stress themselves about building an ETF portfolio. So when there are services providing that exact solution and at a cheap cost that comes from mass adoption, people will flock into investing more in the capital markets. When or how fast this happens is yet to be seen. One thing, however, is certain, the average citizen is curious, and this curiosity is building people's desire to invest. Exposure to precious metals. Put your bubble vision on mute. You do not have to be invested in the market. That is a fallacy. Take what you have and pay down your debts. Join Greg Hunter as he goes one-on-one with former Fed insider Danielle DiMartino Booth, author of the popular book Fed Up. Investing, making it more accessible for the average citizen. One links their Facebook account to the bank, and an investment portfolio is generated. And for nearly no cost, seemingly preposterous. Or is it? This article will explore the shifts in views in investing, new opportunities in the market. We have inflation. We have very real inflation, and it is hitting corporate America between the eyes. We have seen inflation happening, and we continue to see it happening. Rental inflation is off the scale. Inflation is up for 2018, and it has been up. We can have deflation and inflation at the same time. If all of this debt that has built up, especially for households, if they are allocating more of their income to servicing debt, then they have fewer dollars to spend on other things. So, you are going to have deflation and inflation at the same time. What does the regular guy on the street do? Booth says, figure out a way to have automobile delinquencies, and we are starting to see a big tick up in FHA mortgage delinquencies as well. We are at almost 10% delinquencies of FHA mortgage loans. Underlying this sugar high that we will see from all of these hurricanes and rebuilding efforts and wildfires, underneath that, still waters run deep, and the economy is not doing well. We are a consumption-driven economy that is weakening underneath. The sugar high will absolutely wear off in 2018. What about the bond market in 2018? Booth says, we have gone from $150 trillion in global debt in 2007 to $220 trillion and counting today. If you delude yourself into thinking a rising rate environment can be good when we have tacked on $70 trillion of debt in the last decade, you are fooling yourself. It is an accident waiting to happen, and anyone who doesn't think that it will take the stock market down with it is more optimistic than I am by a country mile. Booth says, along with the bond market debacle, the world will see inflation right along with it. Booth explains, look at lumber prices, look at the cost of packaging, plastics, raw materials, the producer price index is at a six-year high right now. It is called the mother of all margin squeezes. Companies are suffering. 2018 economy goes cold, inflation hot. Danielle DiMartino Booth, former Fed insider. Danielle DiMartino Booth is not optimistic about a surging economy in 2018. Booth contends, we have seen 24 consecutive back-to-back months when credit card spending has outpaced incomes. That tells you households are struggling to get by. This is not Yves Saint Laurent handbags and Jimmy Choo shoes. These are families who are using their credit cards to take care of the necessities, to fill up the gas tank, to buy groceries, and fill up their refrigerator. We have seen month after month of subprime